What's up, TFA fam? Welcome to another player profile video. I'm Robby Jeffries, and today I am very pumped up to talk about Trey Sermon, running back for the San Francisco 49ers. This is a guy I liked in the pre-draft process, and I'm even more excited about now that he has landed in San Francisco. So let's dive right in. So Trey Sermon, player profile, he's 6 foot, about 213 pounds. So not the biggest back, not the smallest back. He's right there in the middle. PFF actually had him graded as the seventh highest running back in college football for going back all the way to 2018. So this is a guy that a lot of analytical and statistical places really, really liked coming out as a prospect. You know, he is a powerful downhill runner. You see this in his Oklahoma tape going all the way back to his time there and in Ohio State last year. This guy is a churner. He delivers contact, fights for the extra yards. You're just going to see him as an angry runner, essentially. And I think you'll see this with the 49ers in the type of offense that they run. But not only does he do that, he has a lot of great acceleration. He's a short area quickness guy. He's able to get to the edge. And when he does, he kind of fights for those extra yards. You see these running backs with good bend, as they say, right? The players that have good bend. And that's what Trey Sermon has, is that he's able to shake a lot of would-be tacklers and continue to get extra yards. He actually ranked in the top 10 for elusive seasons twice in college, dating back all the way to 2018. And basically this it just shows how elusive this guy is. And he actually evaded a tackle on 33% of his carries. So every third of his carries, he is evading a tackle, which was up there with David Montgomery and Travis Etienne, two of the more dynamic, elusive backs, tackle-breaking backs that you see in the NFL. So what do we like about him past that? Well, we like his landing spot, right? Like, this is a guy that ends up in a Kyle Shanahan running offense. And everyone's really excited about Trey Sermon. Well, I think they have the wrong Trey that they're pumped up about. I am pumped up about Trey Sermon because of what they've done in this running game in years past. Let's go back to 2019, right? They had the number one rushing offense in terms of touchdowns. They had the number two rushing offense in terms of yards. They had a top eight team in terms of rushing yards per carry. So this is a team that can be really efficient when they're healthy, when they're operating, and then the year that they went to the Super Bowl, they were a team that were absolutely firing in the rushing game. That was with guys like Raheem Mostert. This is with guys like Matt Breida, a little bit of Jeff Wilson then. But, you know, now we have a new guard, right? And everyone's kind of worried about this back, but that's why Trey Sermon is going where he currently is, outside of the top 25 running backs, sometimes outside of top 30 if you look at certain ADPs. And I just think that's absolutely crazy. This is a guy that can be a top 20 running back for you, and I'll tell you why. If we look at his competition in that running back backfield, we have Raheem Mostert. That's the first guy that everyone's going to name. And this is a former journeyman who's kind of been all over the place, really didn't pop until he came into this Kyle Shanahan rushing offense. And from there, he's really done a lot of work. He's been super efficient, but super unhealthy. He does not finish seasons. He does not stay healthy. He's constantly injured, and he's already been injured in this preseason, this training camp season that we've seen in 2021. So this is a guy that's on the last year of his deal, probably not going to be re-signed, an older incumbent back. They move up in the draft to take Trey Sermon in the third round. Actually, they trade up for Trey Sermon's pick. So we see the writing on the wall for Raheem Mostert. He's probably the back that's on his way out. Trey Sermon is the back that they have brought in. They drafted highly, moved up to get him. So this could be a little bit of a split at the beginning of the year, like we saw with some of these backs in 2020, where, you know, Jonathan Taylor doesn't pop right away. Cam Akers doesn't pop right away. Antonio Gibson doesn't pop right away. You know, some of these guys, it took a little bit. J.K. Dobbins is another example. But once they took that backfield over, they were all top 24-ish backs, right? They were running back twos. And I think Trey Sermon is absolutely in that same mold. Raheem Mostert, injury concern, absolutely. Not going to be long for this team. They want to see what they have in Trey Sermon. If we go down the rest of the roster, some people are talking about Wayne Gallman, right? That's a name that people throw out. Some people talk about Elijah Mitchell or Michael Hasty. Honestly, these are just names, guys. These are names that we've known, we've heard before, but Wayne Gallman is a guy that's on the roster bubble. He might make the team, he might not, with Jeff Wilson, another running back for the 49ers, on the PUP. He might make the team, but once Jeff Wilson comes back, I think Wade Gallman is cut. So he is not a concern for four touches for Trey Sermon. Eliza Mitchell, another rookie running back that the 49ers took in the sixth round, actually. A good pass catcher out of the backfield. That's something that people say that Sermon didn't quite show in his college tape, and I believe that's something he can do. He just wasn't asked to do in an offense that was run with Justin Fields, who doesn't throw a lot to his running backs at Ohio State, and then Kyler Murray and some of these other quarterbacks at Oklahoma that didn't, they just didn't throw a lot to their running backs. So we've seen a couple of examples in the preseason where Trey Sermon can catch the football, and I think he will for the 49ers. But Eliza Mitchell, sixth-round pick, could get some work, but I don't think he is a worry for touches in that offense. And then Jamichael Hasty, also on the camp bubble. Either he or Wayne Gallman makes the team as that fourth running back until Jeff Wilson comes back. So, again, a lot of names, a lot of fluff, and it's really suppressing Trey Sermon's his ADP, and I think that's something that should be a lot higher. I think this is a great guy that you can get in that sixth, seventh round that could turn into a top 20 running back. That's right, I said a top 20 running back. So make sure you have him in your queue. I think he's one of the guys that if you're looking outside of the current top 20 ADP, who's a guy that can pop, be that second year or the second half of the year back for you, like a J.K. Dobbins, like a Cam Akers, Jonathan Taylor. This is absolutely that type of profile that you need. I think he has the talent. He has the college production. He has the situation, which is super important to get you fantasy points, not only in the second half of the year, but I think he can mix in early as a first and second down back, mixing in with Mostert a little bit as he takes over that backfield. So make sure you guys are looking for him in your drafts coming up this weekend and in the weeks to come. That's all I have for you on Trey Sermon. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. We have a couple more profiles coming up before your draft season is over and before we start the actual NFL season. Make sure you join our Discord. We're going to have a ton of great fantasy football talk coming for you guys in our Discord chat. The link is in the description. Make sure you jump in and check out all the fun we have going on in there. And stay tuned for the rest of our video. Hit subscribe. Hit the like button. Hit the bell, hit everything. I'm out.